General transport to and from Kabarak-Soro was halted for about 3 hours after the road caved in due to heavy rainfall. According to Victor Badiebuze, a resident of Buara village, the caving in of the road could due to water source adjacent to the road.
That we need to allow only small vehicles to pass here, especially like these trucks, they shouldn't pass here.
Fred Turiamreva, a resident of Shebea village in Shebea parish, has called upon the Uganda National Roads Authority to swiftly intervene with measures of managing the situation. Dennis Twesigome, Rubanda district engineer, has urged road users to be careful while using the road as they wait for government help.
This is a terrible situation that we have not been experiencing, especially this highway. So we just need people's cooperation so that we don't allow other trucks to pass here.
By press time, URA officials were not yet at the scene. However, Alan Sempewa, the URA public relations officer, told our reporter that they're already aware of the situation and they're in discussion with police to assess and decide if they can temporarily close the road.
Whether you know, but you are not a traffic officer, you can see the surface is failing.
Over 50 cargo trucks heading to Rwanda and Democratic Republic of Congo were affected. Local buses and the United Nations High Commission for Refugees convoy of refugees from Chisoro district were blocked by the incident. Kabarak-Soro Road connects Uganda to neighboring Democratic Republic of Congo through Bunagana border and Rwanda through Chanika border. Hamura Kanung Road connects Uganda to DRC through Inshasha border. Meanwhile, environmental experts in Western Uganda have warned residents in the area and other parts of the country to get prepared to face more environmental-related disasters. The National Environmental Management Authority, Western Region Manager Jekonas Musinjiri, attributed the recent floods that caused the destruction of bridges and property in many parts of the country to mismanaging the environment and natural resource base.
By mid this May, more rains would of heavy intensity would come. So that means the incidences and impact will be felt throughout this month of May.
Musinjiri says some rivers have burst in Rukunjiri, Kanungu, Rubanda, Ruchiga and Kasese. They've also registered cases of mudslides because of the heavy rains and fragile soils in the hills.
Some rivers have busted in Rukunjiri, in Kanungu, in Kasese, and even in Kasese we registered there are cases of mudslides because of the heavy rain and because of the fragile soils of the hills. So then we have these rivers of Rubindi, we have the rivers of Wizi. All these have shown the bursting of the buffers of the banks.
He decried minimal funding of environmental sector and politicizing of issues of environment, which are affecting the implementation of environmental laws.
The funds are minimal. Then another thing, politicizing the issues of environment. For example, now scenarios of people losing assets in Mbarara City wouldn't be happening now if the political wing and the business we had done of buffering River Wizi was not made politicized.
Residents and leaders in Barra City have cried out to government, calling for immediate intervention to construct permanent bridges that connect them to city centers. Compiled by Job Namanya and Abdul Karim Sengendo for the news.